4 years after the murder of Dr. Teresa Sievers, a trial date is set and new information about the investigation is coming to light.
The doctor and mother of two children was found dead in her home in 2015. Investigators believe her husband, Mark, hired Jimmy Rogers and Curtis Wright to kill her. Wright admitted to the murder last year. And as NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis learned today in court, he had a major role to play in leading investigators to other suspects.
The judge picking a new trial date, October 1st, for the two men waiting for a jury to hear their case. He says a lot more needs to be done between now and then. But even still, we're learning more about the murder investigation nearly 4 years after it all began.
I am withdrawing that motion.
Moving the case forward as one, the defense attorneys representing Mark Sievers and Jimmy Rogers argued several motions today, one of them being to toss out the term burner phone.
We are objecting to the term burner phone, as it is one, it's slang.
The judge denied that and several other defense motions about jury selection and to throw out a phone data collection.
That violates the constitutional rights, not just of Mr. Sievers, and I know what the state's going to argue, and I'll address that, but of everyone in Lee County, Florida.
Okay, I'm going to deny the motion based on standing.
And talking about Jimmy Rogers.
It was all kind of simultaneous between how loud and manically he was speaking.
And at that time, who was your known suspect?
Curtis Wright.
The judge heard from the two detectives who interviewed him. The defense wanted the judge to toss out this statement.
He said in the state of Missouri, that's 15 to 20 years, and I'm okay with that.
The judge did not decide on that one and admitted that between now and October, there's other decisions that need to be made.
I logistically have to decide where I don't think this courtroom's big enough.
Mark Sievers did appear inside the courtroom today in a wheelchair. I asked his attorneys about it. They tell me it's only a small issue and temporary. They say that it was just easier for him to get back and forth to court today. The judge heard several other motions as well. Go to this story on the NBC2 app if you want to read about those. Reporting inside the Lee County Justice Center, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.